Hi, TransByDef. This is Christine, and I'm your Sunday host. Our topic this week is trans portrayals in the mainstream media and our thoughts about that. So I'll tell you that there are some really well-worn paths in the mainstream media. There's the coming out story, the big reveal that goes on. Those are local stories oftentimes, or there are stories where somebody's being outed, sometimes against their will. You know, Fallon Fox, that being her mainstream name, I suppose, has recently been outed by force. And then in the media, the portrayals of her, the initial outing part, were relatively generous by mainstream standards, but not at all fair to what she's actually been through. And since then, there's been people that have said incredibly transphobic and really hurtful things to her in the media. You know, misgendering her intentionally, saying that she's a man beating on women, you know, calling her names for doing what she does with the fighting. But that's, she's long past transition. She's been a woman for a long time, and yet they still misgender her. And that's still accepted or tolerated by many. Comments in the blogs that go along with the messages are just horrible. And unfortunately, that happens all the time. And we just have a pilot that just transitioned out in LA. He covered, like, the O.J. Simpson pilots. Or the O.J. Simpson car race, and he was flying over. You know, she goes by Zoe now, and, you know, was outed into the media, and on the original article, the comments were horrible. And this is a person who's been out there, who's done nothing bad to anyone, has saved lives. I mean, a documented hero. Just like Kristen Beck, who is just outed into the media because of a book that she published, Warrior Princess. People can be incredibly mean. And the thing is, in the comments, it's pretty stinking common. So even when the media is covering it relatively responsibly, boy, there's a lot of pushback in society. And it's ugly. It's really ugly. And then, too often, it's very stereotypical. And that happened with Kristen when she came out for her CNN documentaries. You know, a lot of it was really stereotypical. It's so stereotypical that there's actually a drinking game. You can do a Google search and you'll find it. It's a trans documentary drinking game. It has wonderful things such as, you have to take a drink if somebody's putting on makeup. Two drinks if they're doing it as a reverse shot in a mirror. you have to take a drink if they're doing anything that's better done in jeans and sneakers, instead doing it in heels and a skirt. Some examples of that would be cleaning the house, shoveling the sidewalk, yard work. there's so many different things here. Before pictures with extreme facial hair, before picture in a uniform, military, football, you know. If you play that game with a trans documentary of any sort, you will be incredibly drunk before it's done. There is no way not to be if you play it fairly. And it's kind of sad that that's how we're portrayed, as if we're you know, a caricature. Like, we're all the same, but we're not. I mean, we all have our own stories and our own paths that we took to get to where we're at. And it's not an unhappy tale. I had somebody message me and tell me that they had been through a really hard time. They got into drinking and drugs and everything else because they were running away from who they were. And they thought for sure that I'd done that too. I didn't. I've drank, but I've rarely drank to excess. You know, I never used drugs. I never smoked. I don't judge people that do. I can understand why they would get there. But that's not me. That's not my story. And that doesn't have to be a trans story. And it shouldn't have to be a trans story at all. If the way that it worked was acceptance and love, then that really wouldn't happen as much, which is why I argue for that whenever I get a chance. Other mainstream portrayals that we see, the crimes. If a trans person ever does something wrong, it's portrayed as if the entire trans community did something wrong, which is ridiculously stupid. Is every minority responsible for what the whole group does? Is that how we judge the group? By the one bad apple? You know, Fox News has been called out just this last week by Media Matters, and there's been quotes in the media about it, about their transphobia, because, you know, they've got Dr. Phil, Bill O'Reilly, I can't remember the name of the host, but he got all in an uproar about a trans person at a bathroom in a restaurant that was approving and accepting of that trans person using the appropriately gendered restroom. You know, they call it out. Sometimes it's really, really depressing. Really depressing. One of the things that happened in the UK this year, a trans person came out, was actually outed in the school newsletter, because they were transitioning and going back to work as a teacher. And this is Lucy Meadows, if you want to do some research on it. And some of the media in the United Kingdom, which is generally considered to be more accepting than the U.S., picked up on it. They called her names. They basically questioned her right to even work. Accused her of harming the kids that she was teaching. And she had a lot of support from the school, from the kids. And yet, she ended up giving up and killing herself. The coroner brought it back into the media recently because of documentation that they received that indicated that really a big part of the cause of death was that media coverage. Not that you can directly say that the media killed her, but they sure played a big part. I don't think the media thinks about what they're doing. Earlier this week, Pamela brought up Jerry Springer, and she had a clip in her video, so you should definitely be watching that, because her video is really good. And, you know, look at what Jerry Springer did. I mean, he basically left us looking like fools. And it's, you know, sometimes, you know, we're seeing people very early in their transition. We're not hearing about the things that they've accomplished in their lives, or we're hearing about somebody doing something unexpected, like Fallon Fox when she's fighting in mixed martial arts. You know, it's unexpected and it's unwelcome because they see it as a man fighting a woman. And so all this, you know, coverage is so negative and it hurts us. And it hurts all of us. And then we've got Fox News. They're not picking on gay people as much now. They're starting to pick on trans people because there hasn't been a big backlash against it. People seem to be relatively tolerant of picking on trans people. So much so that Bryn was publishing her article for the Huffington Post this week. And in it, she said, we have a humanitarian crisis, you know, waiting to occur. Because she thinks the big LGBT organizations are going to start shutting down after marriage equality, which is expected to happen soon based on the polling, and then based on the Supreme Court rulings that are pending. If those organizations shut down and stop fighting against negative portrayals, we might become open season. And that's scary. You know, I didn't transition to find peace with the world. I transitioned to find peace with myself. But at the same time, you know, it would be really nice if the world would leave me alone, and not punish me just because of who I am. Anyway, every once in a while you'll see some good media coverage. You'll see hosts that really get it. Melissa Harris-Perry, I think that's her name, on MSNBC, she has her own show. And she's done some great pieces on trans issues. Laverne Cox is an actress. She has a new show that she's part of that's coming out. It's a Netflix original show. About a prison, a women's prison, and she's one of the stars in the show. Should be a great portrayal of a trans woman in mainstream media, in this case in a movie or TV show. I think that comes out pretty much less than a month away now, so, you know, I'm going to be watching that. Yeah. It's not the best it could be out there. And the media has a long ways to go to really begin to understand our lives, because our lives are rich and diverse and we're doing amazing work, you know, in our industries. You know, we're doing the best we can possibly do, and oftentimes underneath the hardest of conditions. You know, our unemployment rate is far higher than the general populace. We can do better, but it'd be nice if society was supporting us and if the mainstream media started to understand our plight, started to, you know, get behind us. I mean, it's a sad day when New York can't pass gender after they've passed same-sex marriage, after they have LGB protections in their law. They can't protect their trans people, even though public support was there at like 75%. What's up with that? It's a sad day. We got a long ways to go. We're probably 20 to 30 years behind the LGB movements. And once we get there, we're still going to have people that hate us. But it's kind of nice to be able to be yourself and to show them that they're wrong. So keep doing that.